Good morning, children. Yes, once again, welcome back to our online classes. Yes, in the morning session we discussed about yes polygons. In that about yes quadrilaterals we have seen, and quadrilaterals means a rectangle. It can have how many triangles? Two triangles. And next pentagon, it can have yes polygon pentagon, three triangles, and hexagon, four triangles. Next septagon, five triangles. Yes, how? The number of triangles is equals to total number of sides minus 2. You subtract, then we get the number of triangles. Then inside angle, the sum of the angles, the sum of the angles of the quadrilateral, that is yes a rectangle, pentagon, hexagon, that we can calculate. Now here a polygon with the four sides is called quadrilateral. Quadri means it is four. Quadri, this is nothing but four. Lateral means sides. Four sides, quadrilaterals, four sided figures. In this session we will discuss about the quadrilaterals. First write the definition of quadrilateral. Quadrilateral, yes, quadrilateral is a simple closed figure. Yes, this is also a polygon, yes, with four sides. Quadrilateral, a polygon with four sides is called quadrilateral. Quadrilateral. Yes, a polygon with the four side is called quadrilateral. Here the sum of the measures of the quadrilateral is equals to 360 degree. Here sum of the angles of quadrilateral is 360 degree. Here we can draw a quadrilaterals one by one. First I will draw, yes, this is a square with the help of a ruler. First one, square. Yes, we learnt all these in the previous classes, but here also we will draw. Yes, in this square all sides are equal in length. All sides are equal in length, and the sum of the angles of the square is 90 degree. Sum of the squares of angles is 360 degree. Yes, here all angles are of 90 degree. A, B, C, D. This is also 90 degree. This is also 90 degree. This is also 90 degree, and this is also 90 degree. Here these all are equal in length. All are equal in length. That's why this similar sign indicates yes equal. Similar sign indicates equal, and they are in parallel. They all similar means this single also we can give, or double also we can give. Yes, one I will give. And this arrow mark shows they are parallel. They are parallel lines. These two are parallel, and these two are parallel. We can write square. Square, all sides of equal length. ABCD is a square, all sides of equal length. All sides of equal length. That is AB is equals to line segment AB is equals to AC is equals to BD is equals to and CD. All are equal in length, all line segments. Now then we can say here all angles are equal of measures. All angles have angles, right angles, equal measures means we can write all angles. All angles are right angles. All angles are right angles. That is, angle A is equals to angle B is equals to angle C. Angle D is equals to 90 degree. All are 90 degree angle. And one more, we can say here opposite sides are parallel. Opposite sides are parallel. Here write opposite sides are in parallel. Yes, which are those? AB is parallel to CD. We can write AB is parallel to CD. Line AB or line segment, you write like AB is parallel to CD, and this AC is parallel to BD. AC is parallel to BD. AC is parallel to BD. This is about square. Square means it has four, yes, line segments, four sides, all are equal in length and four angles. Its total is quadrilateral. Quadrilateral means it has 360. 90 plus 90, 180. 180 plus 180, 360 degree. Yes. And next one is about a rectangle. About rectangle, we learnt in the previous times that is different about square. A square has four vertices, four sides, all sides are equal, like that much only. But here all angles are equal and opposite sides are parallel. That this is new. These two are new for you. This equal length we learnt. And here also in rectangle also we can draw a rectangle. Yes, very simple this is. Yes, in rectangle also here opposite sides are equal and they are parallel. Opposite sides are equal, this is we can name as PQRS. Here these two are equal and these two are equal. Opposite sides are equal and they are parallel. These two are parallel. Then about the rectangle, opposite sides here, opposite sides are equal in length. That is PQ is equals to RS and this PR is equals to QS. PR is equals to QS. Opposite sides are equal in length. Then we can take next here parallel. Opposite sides are parallel. We can write all the angles are here also right angles. All the angles are right angles. Yes, these here 90 degree. Yes, all the angles are right angles. That is angle P is equals to angle Q is equals to angle R is equals to angle S 90 degree. These are all 90 degree. Then we can write opposite sides are parallel. Here also opposite sides are parallel. That is PQ is parallel to RS and PR is parallel to QS. PR is parallel to QS. Write this one. Write these two figures, draw neatly, and write in your notebook. After this, some more quadrilaterals we have, and third one we discuss, that is parallelogram. This is new to you, parallelogram. Yes, it has same like rectangle only. Yes, but here opposite sides are equal, opposite sides are parallel, but angle is different. Here angles are, here all angles are 90 degree in this rectangle, but in this parallelogram, yes, opposite angles are equally measures. Then we can write parallelogram. Parallelogram, yes, LOGRM, yes. This is here opposite sides are equal in length. If it is of 8-10 cm, then slope here you can take 6 cm. Then again 10 cm. It should be 6. Yes, this is the parallelogram. Here also the opposite sides are equal. These two are equal and these two are equal. This is parallel to this one and this is parallel to this one. Here angles are different, same like this only. Here we can name it as EMLOP. MLOP. Here, yes, this M angle is equals to O angle. Opposite angles are equal. This N angle is equals to single angle, same R. N angle is equal to P angle. Angle N is equals to angle P. Here this side equal and parallel. This side equal and parallel. But angles only change. Then we can write all same, only opposite angles are equal. Opposite angles are equal, like that parallelogram. Yes, opposite sides are of equal length. Opposite sides are of equal length. What are those opposite sides? That is MM is equals to OP. ML is equals to OP and MP is equals to ON. MP is equals to ON. Then we can write opposite angles are equal in measures. Opposite angles are of equal measures. That is angle M is equals to angle N and angle O is equals to, sorry, angle O, angle N is equals to angle P. Angle N is equals to angle P. And next one more, that is parallel. Opposite sides are opposite sides are parallel. We can write parallel. Yes, then MN is parallel to OP or PO and MP is parallel to ON. Yes. Write this one also about parallelogram. It has, yes, opposite sides are equal in length. Then opposite sides are parallel. Opposite angles are equal. Very simple. This is about this parallelogram. Next is trapezium. This is also new to you. Quadrilateral. Next quadrilateral is trapezium. The trapezium also has four angles. Here one pair of sides are parallel. One pair of sides are parallel and one pair of angles are equal in measures. We can write fourth one, trapezium. Yes, this figure is very simple. Yes, like this. Only one pair of lines are parallel. Yes, we can take this is E, F, Z, H. Here this line is parallel to EF, is parallel to GH or HG. EF is parallel to HG and these are same length. These two are same length, opposite. Here this angle it is equal to this angle and this one angle is equals to this angle. Yes, pair of angles are equal in measures and you can write for this only one pair of opposite sides are parallel. Only one pair of lines are opposite. Only one pair of opposite sides are parallel. That is, yes, EF is parallel to GH. EF is parallel to GH. Only one pair. And this is not parallel. If you extend this, they will meet at a point. Yes, next is about the other two non-parallel sides are called slant lines. Yes, these other two, yes, non-parallel sides, these are slant lines. The other two non-parallel sides are called slant sides. Yes, they are slant sides. Next, when the measure of slant sides are same, it's called isosceles trapezium. When these are slants of same measure, then we can call them as the isosceles trapezium. Yes, write this much. Yes, we can write the third point. When the measures of slant sides are same, these are equal, then you can say isosceles. How isosceles triangle is there? No, two sides are equal, these two are equal, then isosceles triangle like that also. Here we can call this as isosceles trapezium. That point you can write when the measures of slant sides are, when the measures of slant sides are equal, slant sides are same, then yes, it is called an isosceles trapezium. ऐसा प्लस ट्रापेजियम। यस देन हियर एन एसोसेलस, एसोसेलस ट्रापेजियम हैज टू पेयर ऑफ सिमिलर एंगल्स एंड एसोसेलस ट्रापेजियम हैज ट्रापेजियम हैज टू पेयर ऑफ इक्वल एंगल्स, टू पेयर्स ऑफ सिमिलर एंगल्स। यस हियर व्हाट वी ड्रॉ, दिस इज एन आइसोसेलस, यस वी कैन से व्हेन द मेजर्स ऑफ स्लैंट स्लाइड्स आर सेम इट इज कॉल्ड एन आइसोसेलस ट्रैपेजियम एंड आइसोसेलस ट्रैपेजियम हैज टू फेस ऑफ सिमिलर एंगल्स here this pair and this two are similar angles and this two are similar then one pair two pair of similar angles this is about trapezium next one is about the quadrilateral that is a rhombus next quadrilateral is a rhombus we'll see about that rhombus and one more we have that is kite rhombus and kite very simple these quadrilaterals You should remember they are slight only in one point they are differ from one to another this parallelogram and rectangle only one point is there to differ and kite and square only one point is it is there differ like that yes here the next quadrilateral is about rhombus fifth one it is about rhombus we'll draw a diagram yes this rhombus is all sides are equal in length and yes opposite sides are parallel this is the figure of rhombus here all sides are equally length opposite sides are parallel this and this are parallel and this one parallel yes all sides are equal in length yes here all sides of equal length we can write rhombus all sides of equal length yes that is equals to here the name we can name it h I j k then h i is equals to I j or j I that is equals to k j and that is equals to h k h can you see this one yes HK here next point is opposite sides are equal measures here this opposite sides are equal measures here opposite all sides are opposite angles are equal measures and opposite sides are parallel opposite angles are of equal measures measures. Then we can write, yes, this angle and this angle are equal, and this angle and this angle are equal. Angle H is equals to angle J, and angle I is equals to angle K. Opposite angles are of equal measures. Then we can write opposite sides are parallel. That is, HI is parallel to KJ or JK, and yes, HK is parallel to IJ. HK is parallel to IJ. This is about rhombus. Only slight change in square and this. All sides are equal. Opposite angles are equal. Here, there all angles are 90 degree. Here opposite sides also, there here also parallel, there also parallel, but only about the angles it is different, slight difference from square. And next is about kite. Yes, kite, it is a figure, two distinct pair of adjacent sides of equal length. Yes. This is a figure of kite. Yes. Now, these two are equal sides and these two are equal sides. We can name it as TQRS. TQRS. Here, these opposite sides are, here one see now, this side, adjacent sides are equal. Adjacent sides are equal. Two distinct pair of adjacent sides are of equal length. Two distinct means two different. Two distinct, yes, you can write two distinct pairs of adjacent sides of equal length. Sides of equal length. Yes. Then next is, here we can write PQ is equals to QR and PS is equals to RS. PS is equals to RS. One pair of opposite angles are equal measures. One pair of opposite angles are equal measures. Here this pair, these two angles are equal in measures. One pair of equal measures of angle. One pair of opposite angles of equal measures. That is, angle P is equals to angle R. Here we can write angle P is equals to angle R. Write down these two also about rhombus and kite. After this, we can solve exercise. That is a very simple exercise. Write these two also in your notebook neatly. Yes. About this quadrilaterals, very simple exercise is there. That we can see now. Open page number, textbook page number 157. Identify the figure, quadrilateral, name it. Identify the quadrilateral and name it. Yes, here, first question, identify and write the name of each quadrilateral. Mark equal angles in each of the quadrilaterals given below. Yes, question number one. Right question from textbook. I am writing the answers. A. This is which quadrilateral it is? Name of this one? Yes, it is square. It is square. Mark the equal angles in each of quadrilateral given below. Angles. Yes, these two are equal angles. These two are all four angles are equal here. B. This is trapezium. Yes. They given these two sides are equal. These two sides are equal means then we can the angles equal angles. Here we can draw an equal angles. Next is C. This is trapezium. Can write trapezium. Yes. Next figure is which shape it is? Yes, a rectangle. Here all sides, all angles are equal. Write its name, a rectangle. Next is only mark only angles. Kite. Yes, these angles are equal. We can write it as K-I-T-E, kite. E. E1. Yes. This is all sides equal means a rhombus. This is rhombus. Angles opposite side, opposite angles are equal. It's mark the angles. Next is parallelogram. Which figure is given? Parallelogram. These two are equal. This one are equal. Then we can, yes, here also opposite angles are equal in measures. Opposite angles. Yes, return this name you write. This is parallelogram. Yes. After this, again, mark the equal parallel sides. Here, mark the equal parallel sides is there. And question number 3, 4. These are very simple questions are there. You can solve page number 157. If you get any doubt about these quadrilaterals, you can give a call to me. I will clear your doubt. With this, I will conclude today's my class. Yes, if you get any doubt, you can give a call in any time. Okay, thank you.